Hello, welcome to another episode of the Three Blind Mice group build with Time Riders, Wee Little Cars, and Fat Man Productions, Polly out there in beautiful Las Vegas, and me, Hodges Hot Wheels and Diecast. For this time around, we are going to be doing the number 41, the Ford GT40. Beautiful car built by Carroll Shelby, built to race in Le Mans and other races overseas to compete with the Ferraris and Porsches. And from what I gather, it did very well. So I usually very seldom take one of these 175th regular wheels and do a custom on them. But I'm going to make an exception on this one because I have a couple of these castings and I've already restored one to original condition. So we're going to get a little crazy on this one and make it really, really cool. So just remember, when you get done here watching my videos, go over and check out Time Riders and Paulie's and Fat Man Productions, and we're all doing the same casting, so you can get three different takes on the same car as you did last month, and it's going to be sexy. So stay tuned, let's take this thing apart. Okay, here we are with our disassembled Ford GT40. As I failed to mention before I disassembled, this is another one of the nice, very generous donations by Anthony Bellini. A lot of us modelers know him very well because he's very generous with his matchbox, and he likes to send them out to us to get restored. He's done it all over the world. He's a very, very nice person to do this, and very thankful. And I don't know whether this was one of his originals or not, but it's been enamel painted. You can see just underneath there, you can still see the decal. And we're going to strip this baby down. It's in really good shape. And here's our engine. Very nice detailing. We're going to go ahead and paint that up really, really nice looking. And that way you can see it through the back window. It'll look really cool. As for the interior, it's pretty good. It's in great condition, just good cleaning, and I'm going to paint it a different color. I got to figure out which color I'm going to paint to go through. And for this, we aren't going to use these wheels for this one, so we will put those away, and we'll be do some tire fitting and all that, and we'll go from there. I'm going to get this into the paint stripper and see where we are, so stay tuned. Okay, and we're back from the paint stripper. And overall, this is a pretty nice casting. It's got a lot of nice details. Pretty close to the original, I would assume. Just one thing that really bothers me on this is the front end. If you look at the front end, it's pretty two-dimensional. I mean, I have a Hot Wheels one here. And you can see there's an opening, and it's slanted more right here, as you can see on here. Whereas this one is like a point. So I got some meat up here. I need to modify this front end because it bothers the hell out of me. There you go. I put some black Sharpie on there, paint marker, and I think that's where the opening needs to be. Pretty much I need to file it flat first a little bit and get that contour a little bit better. It's too pointed in the front. I'm gonna try to fix that and maybe put a little bit of an opening in the front. We have to do a little body work, but I'm not leaving it like this. It just doesn't look right. So with what I'm doing with it, it's just not going to work. So let me do a little bit of fabrication here, modification, and we'll see where we are when we get back. Stay tuned. Okay, and we're back after a lot of filing and a lot of sanding, getting the casting lines out of the back quarter panels and just making this whole front end look like it should. I still have some more I want to do to it with some styrene, put a little bit of some lower spoiler on it, put some air ducts, but as you can see, she looks from the front more appropriate now compared to the lines. Put some little spoilers and air ducts on there. This thing's gonna look sweet. So that was the biggest thing that was bothering me. So we did a little styrene work, still playing around with the wheels. Don't know what I want to put on here yet. Know what I want to do with paint, just got to get it to that point, which should be very shortly. So stay tuned for more fun. I'm really digging this. Front end looks 100% better. Holy shit, what is George doing now? Well, on all my pictures, those front scoops were just not right for me. So I shot them full of holes. No, seriously. I looked at this one and I've looked at pictures. These aren't as deep, but I am going to file these out and lay styrene underneath, and it's going to look real cool because it gets painted black. Big air scoops. And it didn't anything structurally. So stay tuned for more madness. Okay. This is where we're at right now. I ended up getting the hood scoops, or the hood vents, cut all the way in and put styrene on the backside. We cut the hole in the front to make it look correct. We put these little spoilers on the front just like the race cars do, and two air ducts right up there underneath where the vents are. I saw them in a picture and it looked really cool, and that's what was missing. There was nothing on the front of this thing. So we're going to, I've got everything shot in Quicksilver Chrome. What I'm going to do is a golf theme, like they raced in Le Mans. And we're going to, I can do it in flat and regular straight enamels, but let's do something a little bit wild. We're going to spectra flame this thing in golf light blue and orange and see how that looks. So that's my plan. I've got all the body work done to this thing. I'm happy with the way it turned out. I hope you think it looks as cool as I do. I think the front end looks 100% better. If you can see it. I just lowered this thing to see if you can see a little better. So, there you have it. Stay tuned for the next step. I'm going to shoot the base with some Steinerez Black and then Wicked Black over that, and then it gives you a nice satin finish. And we'll start taping this baby off. It's going to be sweet. Okay, and we're back. We are going to get ready to start and paint this Ford GT40 with we're going to start with the light blue. Now what I have is, we're going to do this in Spectra Flame, so I have Windex and I have clear coat, and I'm going to use Austin's way of thinning this down with clear coat. The Windex with the clear coat, the light and the color. So I'm hoping that that will give me the correct tint of blue that I am looking for this golf car, or something close. It doesn't have to be perfect, but I had some of my viewers wanted me to start filming some of the more of the procedures after a couple of my viewers said, well, your videos are a little bit long, a while back, and I cut them down. So I'm going to go ahead and film a little bit of the painting on this Ford GT40, so stay tuned. Okay, here we are.
over at the Downdraft paint booth. And
we got our Spectraflame clear coat, or our urethane clear coat, and our Spectraflame Windex. So let's see what I can do here. See what that does. See if that will be
sufficient. And cannot forget the hardener, otherwise you're going to be waiting for this thing to dry for 10 days, seems like. But it's pretty low humidity and hot today, but I'll probably just take this outside and let it sit.
For good luck. This is just my hardener, to anybody who doesn't know that yet. Haven't filmed painting in a while, so bear with me. Take my coffee stirrers here. Compliments. They were donated by Sheets. They didn't know it, but they did donate them in my pocket. Thank you, Sheets, for the coffee stirrers. Okay. I like to make sure this stuff is really stirred up good. And then I just put my finger over the end and lightly pull the trigger. And if you can look in there, I don't know if you can give some blubs for Jimmy. It's bubbling. Blah, 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 blah. So, those are blubs for Jimmy. So, tie into one of the other stations. There you go, Austin. Thank you for showing me how to
reduce this colors to make them lighter. So, I think I am ready. I'm going to start painting. So, stay tuned.
Okay, and we're back with the lightened up Windex. It's maybe just a hair darker than a golf color, but it is Spectraflame, so I think it'll be just fine. It's turned out really beautiful. All I got left to do now is take this Spectraflame orange and reverse tape everything here in the center, and we will paint this silver stripe orange. And then the fun stuff starts, where we go ahead and do all the other colors, which should be exciting, like the black pinstripes down either side of the orange, the white circles for the numbers. I don't have any numbers for it, but we'll just have to do without those. But we will get it done here, and maybe we'll leave the numbers off of this one. I'm not sure yet. But we'll see what happens, what time allows, and we'll take it from there. So stay tuned. I'll take this off and get it painted. Okay, here we are. And we are almost ready for assembly. As you can see, the windshield Turned out really nice and clean. I just used my Meguiar's polish with my buffing wheel on my Dremel. The engine compartment is nice and detailed. Got the two pipes coming out the back. Got white headers. Blue Ford blue engine. We all know that. And instead of red, we shot the interior just standard black, just like the race cars would. And I've added air spoilers. They look kind of funny here, but they, once I put them on the car, you'll understand what they look like, what they're supposed to look like. And we filed out the center here, made two air ducts, just like the ones did on the originals. So there we have it, one sexy GT40 ready for assembly. So stay tuned for the assembly. I'm not going to show you the body until the final reveal. So if I showed you that, it wouldn't be a surprise. So stay tuned. Hello. The time you've been waiting for is finally here. We have our three blind mice, Matchbox, regular wheels, Ford GT40. And mine is finally done. So without further ado, I'd like to show you what I got. And if you like the decals that I've used today, you can find these right on eBay at secondchanceredlines.com. It has them on there. You'll see these again in my TV car set. I had two sets, so I used one on here. So without further ado, here we are. I'm going to go ahead and let you see what my work of art. Here it is. The Ford GT40 by Matchbox. I have totally, like as you saw earlier, we added the scoops to the air ducts to the front, the hood, and to the front nose to show what it looked like when it raced at Le Mans. These numbers aren't correct for this car, although Le Mans in 1969 was won by a Golf Ford GT40, but I don't remember the numbers. This is actually a Porsche 917 numbers for the Le Mans car, but they work perfectly on this one for display sake. We used Auto World wheels. We used Second Chance Redline decals. We use Spectre Flame paint from the Redline shop. We used Windex blue and we used Spectre Flame orange. We changed we toned them down with some clear coat mixing it so it wouldn't be so dark. And we used Createx paints Wicked Colors Wicked Black on the interior, the base, the engine, and as you saw, we detailed out the engine compartment, we buffed the windshields, we added those little spoilers on the front, which if you look at a lot of pictures from this era of racing, these GT40s had it. We added the air scoops underneath the front there. So this is about as good as I can get it, and I'm really proud of it. It shines like glass. So when you're done here, if you haven't already, please go over to Time Riders Wee Little Cars. And when you're done there, go over to Fat Man Productions and go see what Paulie has done. We all are going to have awesome, awesome builds on this race car. So I hope you've enjoyed this as much as I've enjoyed building this car. I read all your comments. I respond to all your comments. I hope you liked it. I hope you like my take on a classic Matchbox. I usually don't do customs on these except unless it's something really damn good, and this is something really damn good. So I'm really proud of this one. I hope you've enjoyed it, and stay tuned for next month. We'll be doing something else really cool. So have a nice weekend, and we'll catch you on the next build. Stay tuned.
Oh, I almost forgot. Look how happy Mr. T is. Look what he got. Thanks to a close friend of mine who made a couple donations to the channel, we now have, Mr. T has his correct 18 van, which happens to be a vintage Ertl, which is in very good condition. I know the wheels are horrible on them, but it still has all the tampos on it. And this one doesn't have decals on it. This one actually has tampos. So I'm going to just clean it up and leave it alone and let Mr. T enjoy it. He's been pissed off at me ever since I did the super fantastic build off and gave him a free candy van out of his one van. So he's happy. You can see a smile on his face. Give Mr. T some good comments too. So see you next week.